concept of Sama Mikelem is against what people think. Kelly has taken it. Everybody, it's a concept of Teva of the people. Against a Teva of people. Is how much you get. The world thinks how much you get, you need more vacation. Like I said yesterday. Yeah, how much you get closer to Hashem, it means I need to relax. Like yesterday, though, my son heard from Moshe Terumbuk. He said to him, after Shavuos, people didn't relax. They slept all night. They're up all night, they have to relax. According to Sabbath Mikelem, is opposite. We're learning this. And there goes the same thing also. You get a favor. Let's say a person gets, I give a gift to everyone here in the Bismedish. Everyone gets $10,000 for every month for all his life. $10,000 a month without money, without work. So what happens if you get this amount of money? So Tab AC think, listen now, how I can relax, I can less pressure. And the Sami Kelim is opposite. We learn through the Sami Kelim. The third thing he said, how much you understand more, it means you have to have more. You're able to usually tell of the world is you understand more, you have to work less. And here we learn how much you understand more, recognize you have to work hard. That's not the piece. This is the beginning. And we go back to the biggest chiddush we didn't finish yesterday. It says, Vivdatis Aleviim, Mitob B'nei Yisrael V'yu Aleviim. Hashem took the Leviim, become the Bechoirim, He took the Leviim. Vivdatis Aleviim, Mitob B'nei Yisrael V'yu Aleviim. So look at Rashi, he says, because the Leviim, they didn't go after the eagle. And Mashiach and Bechor Yisrael said they lost out. So what Hashem gave responsibility to the Leviim? Two responsibilities. He gave them to serve the Klal Yisrael. The Leviim after Mesharis Klal Yisrael. And second, he gave Avodas HaMishkan to take care of the Mishkan. So now, Sami Mikelem comes and he says he wants to make a Hekesh to a Beis Medrash. How Yav Yeshiva has to be? How to be the avoiders? Now, Kelim Yeshiva, and this is how Kelim was Yeshiva was. I said yesterday, how much you want Torah more, you have more responsibility. How much more less Torah? Less mitzvah. How much you closer to Hashem? More yoga. They used to say in Kelim, who cleans the Aron HaKodesh? Who learns more Torah? Who cleans the base? How much you more closer to Hashem? This is the way you get more. The thing. So now we learn this is the piece. Or Pashas Ba'alo Yisro. The biggest song you learn. Pashas Ba'alo Yisro B'ches Pasud Yudalit. Iran, it says three things we saw for this thing. What we saw. Ladas. Ki Akorov Eilov Hashem Yisborach. If you close to Hashem, what is the schar? You have more avodas Hashem. Not you close to Hashem, it means you have less avodas Hashem. If you close to Hashem, by definition, you have to have more avodas Hashem.
Not more, growing.
More avodas olam. Tikdal avodas olam.
You gotta keep that means to grow. It doesn't mean to.
No. Tikdal means it comes more. Tikdal is more. More there's more. Gadel means more.
But that means, wait, what? That's literally what that's been. You gotta think that when you.
No, Gadel means. Gadel is you have a kamus X.
Yeah.
And Gadel means kamus more.
So that's called growth. That's not more. That's a mesuba of a male, what you're saying. Growth is a process. When you're saying the mesuba, not the thing itself.
Okay,
but
how do you say?
Growth, is there more of a plan?
We're talking about a male versus the dafka.
Okay. I'm not arguing about it. I'm not arguing the lashon. You said the word tikdal here. Yes, the same thing. It's not the point. Next thing. Next point.
Not the point.
Abchaim is not the point. No, I got the idea. I heard what you said. It says Tigla. I heard what you said.
It's not meaning concept.
Can be true. I don't know yet. I'll think about it. And I can be right, you have a point, but even the point you have to see and the picture when it makes a difference. We see the difference.
Okay.
I heard you, I see you all, it says tick that. It doesn't say more, it says tick that. Okay? Let's get the concept. This is the first. Second thing. The Gamiran also shows you Ladas, Shemish Yeshko Toivo. If Hashem has, you have something in your good thing, Miuchad is a good Toivo. Ah, now I'm a person, that I could understand the Sugya. So that gives you Avodah, it gives you also Tigdal Avodah Sod. The Avodah Sod has to be more.
Same
voice. Okay. Grow more. How you want to say it? The Magdiv Suds, not the. Before Shaitim Shah, the Mamid of Chest Yudzai. Kili Bechor Kobe Israel, Ein Shem Berash Shah. We were explaining yesterday, and I'm going to go. Begami Ranu. There's a third thing, the three things we see. We're so in this very soil, these three things, these three concepts. Ladash Komisha Korosoy Muruba, if you understand more, Yoitel Tigdal Akoro Avoida. If you understand, you recognize more, your avoidance Hashem comes more.
Or growth.
Or growth more. I explained it, we'll go to another Nakuda. I will think about it, let's get the idea. So we have three things here. Listen, everybody, three things. One, two, three. If you're close with Hashem, who wants to be close to Hashem? Everybody. So get close to Hashem means you have more, you have to grow more in Avodah Hashem. Second thing, if you have things special in you, good things special in you, you're smart, you have power, strong, good personality, you know more, who knows what, more, you have something in you good, it means you have more extra growth in Avodah Hashem. Third thing is if you understand more, you recognize more in Avodah Hashem, it means you have more respond, more growth in Avodah Hashem. Three things. So, after we know these three things, this is a new change, all the concept of all your life. We'll see soon, we'll see her, the Chidushim, and come home. Because every day you come to the Beis Medrash, like the Rosh Yeshiva said yesterday, and we learned just as she said, "Ein Beis Medrash v'lo Chiddush." Said, but the difference is, if not, you come to the Beis Medrash. The guy comes to the Beis Medrash and he finished the day. The Rosh Yeshiva said this. It's like, "Rabbi, and you know if you got something out of the Beis Medrash, you were not here. Maybe your physical here, your body was here." Rabbi Hoshiva says, "I doesn't need your body. I need your bimis spoil. I have to get excited in the chidushim of Hashem gives you."
They just have to create it. Means that you could contribute to how it came out.
No, it doesn't have to you. And you heard it, Bimis Medrash. It doesn't come from you. It doesn't have to be from you. You heard.
Okay, good. Okay,
this is the point.
You said it was you.
No. I said no. It means you heard Hoshiva from Hoshiva. It also doesn't have to be from you. Has to be a chidush.
Okay.
So now, it means every day is new growth. Every day, Chaim, will have to be new growth in Avodas Hashem. It means to say every day a more responsibility, more growth in Avodas Hashem, not less.
If you have those three parts.
No. This only one three. Everything is my mifnatzwa. Not all these
things. Any one of them.
Okay. So, and the definition is, if you said, if you understand more, it means you're more responsible. You're more with this Hashem. More you have to grow.
More than what? More than the average?
No, more.
More than what?
More than yesterday.
How do you know it's more than yesterday?
More. It doesn't say well, more.
Yeah, but more. You get
one again. I get this. Chaim, you can make difference. See what the 100.
But you're making one way.
Okay, you can say this, you can say that way. I'm not arguing that. I don't need the concept. More, you have to wear the same more. How you make this way, that way, this way. So here you see here a foundation. Soon you'll see enough gemina gdoila ad meoid will change your davening every day. This you will see now today, this would change your davening. You'd be a different davening after this. Not Stam. He's telling you, listen, this thing. Now you will see, because the Mishkan, he says clearly, is a definition of Beis Medesh, Beis Knesses, Mokom HaMikdash. And who is the Leviim? Who is the people that are serving in the Shiva? Who? Everyone here, the Beis Medesh here, like the Rambam says, they call Leviim. Everyone in the Shiva is like the Leviim. Shiva heard, please, Rambam say before Shana Rambam. So now, he tells you what is Yavod now. Now he tells like this. כי שום בפרשת בעלו ישחו כוסו פוסו חי כך הסלבים תחס כל בחור בני ישראל ואת הסלבים תלסים לאר נבולו וגוסר גדול שלא יהיו תומד. הכוח הראשה זה לכם. What is the Leviim? Hashem gave to Leviim. Two things. ישר עשו אסחיהם that they serve the brothers because they are more special, they understand more, they close to Hashem more, and they have a quality more that they serve the brothers. They're not frayerim. They're not because they call you have more money, it means you have to give more, you have to be always, you have responsibility more to give more stocker. You have to work in the, you not be the door, give stocker, give stocker. More money, more responsibility, more giving more. You have to more, you have to serve more, more chachma, more serving, more, everything is in more. The gam, a mishkan kolam ala mosi, you have to carry the mishkan and serve him as amigdash. Now, this gives you three concepts that change our life here today. Three is soldiers, dirtiest, annoyed. Rabbi Sai, listen to the biggest soldier. He says, Lama, not run away from Rabbi Hashem. Seven lines from the bottom, the word Lama. Lama amis alecha avoido. You have to put on yourself lamos. Baruch Hashem yom yom yamos lom. We have to omes. You have to be no time. Lamos heist lamis. Carry and you avoid this Hashem. So all these things that tell you not to run away, to put on your yom avoid this Hashem. Beis the second thing. Ubi prat. כי כל המשכון, העיקר אוילוס, כושר עם כלל ישראל, לדאוג את תיקון גופה ונפשו. All the tachlis of the Leviim is to help כלל ישראל, the mishkon. They do all the korbonos and everything. And now, this is the big chidush admoed. What is the chidush here? Listen. He says, the chidush here, והוא, עניין שתפילוסי נתקים בלא שום רבים. When we daven, why we say refoeim ashiveinu, refoeinu v'chayoytze b'zeh. Says it in the big chiddush. Because we are daven for Klal Yisrael. Because we are the Leviim. We are in the yeshiva, everyone in the yeshiva is a Levi. But Rambam says, no, like, everyone who wants to is serving Hashem is called a Levi. So what Hashem wants you to care about Klal Yisrael and not to say Refoeini. The Rosh Hashanah used to say, don't say Refoeini, only make me healthy. Ashiveini, make me only close to Hashem. So you have to train yourself to daven for Klal Yisrael. Refoeinu Hashem in Erofe. Ashiveinu. Oshiva Shofteinu Kiborishoino. Everything has to be Loshon Rabbi. Not Lashon Yochid, has to be Lashon Rabbim. So you will think to say, well, when you do Lashon Rabbim, you don't grow from it. Yes, this is the biggest mistake. There's it, when you care about Klali, so you think you grow from it, the prime. This is, says, Ki aledei zeh, underline it, Ki aledei zeh, titale maile saodo moi moi nisalo, when you Dava for the Klal, Refoeinu, Atoloife, I'm losing myself. I'm not diving for myself, I'm diving for the cloud. So you know, I'm not gaining. No. Because you don't stand the tachlis. Because you're the Levi. And you have to take care of Klali. So you have to. What did the Levi do the Mishkan? And what they did with the Mishkan? Care about Klali Israel. Care about what the Levi did in Mishkan? All the Kabbalists and everything. All the with blood and killing, shechting and everything. And the Kohanim and Levi did the thing. So are we in the yeshiva like Kohanim and Levi? And we have to do the serving Hashem of davening. So what is our job we have to do? Change our essence. And change our essence. We have to help Klal Yisrael. By how? By davening Loshun Rabin. Not, I daven for myself. I come to daven. All the angels is me, and me, and me, and me. You have to change yourself. Be change all your personality and all your essence to care about Klal Yisrael. And always think about Klal Yisrael. And you think, and then you come, you have, then you grow that way. And this way you grow. Maile Odomoy. Now, now it tells you the third thing. The third thing tells you how to work on your leaders. Vagimel. Ayom erev yom asiri liminyonu. You have to know in Kelem, they used to have anoga, it's called Asiri Kodesh. Asiri Kodesh. Who knows what Asiri Kodesh means? No, what that means? No, they had a different calendar like this. A 10-day, they used to do like this. Every 10 days in Kelem, every 10 days, that day is only fashion. No going to stores, no go to the banks, no go to the nothing. And Kelem that Anoga. Every 10 days, and the 10th day, from the night to the day, that day only serving Hashem, nothing else. Like Yom Kippur, Asiri, that day, so that day is only for Hashem. That is special. If you look in the books, that they're trained, what? It's called Asiri Kodesh. What do you say? Hi? What? No. It's not that. So what is the avoider? Listen, he says. And avoider is emidos, working on emidos. He says like this. Achinu atzmechem achonu rabo. You have to prepare yourself achonu rabo. What does achonu rabo mean? Ukedai aleinu nigzo tanios b'dinad. Really, you have to do tanis the fast. What you have to do in the city Kodesh? Fasting. But Loitani Saguv, underline that. Very important to know. Loitani Saguv, not to fast physically. You have to eat. You have to eat of energy, not to fast physically. Like tiny sanefesh. Only tiny what? Of the nefesh. Midvorim she'enu mo'ulim. Things that you don't need.
Smartphone.
Things that we said last Mussar Shavuos, we said. You have to train yourself things that you don't need, don't have. See, is we.
Does it will help?
Does it help you?
Didn't mean help and need.
Mo'il.
Mo'il needs help, right?
Mo'il is to help and need you. Mo'il. And in English, Mo'il.
I have a different concept. What's the concept?
Mo'il. That the what's things the they don't need. Heter. Mo'il, what is Mo'il?
Whatever help your soul, it'll help your soul. You need. Who is you?
Things I don't need.
Who is you?
Don't help
your soul, your body, what?
It goes by the nefesh. Tanis ha-nefesh, ma'advorim eino mo'ilim. Things that doesn't help you. Doesn't help you. Doesn't work. Kol shekein, you have to be of a tinis from what? Mitvorim asuri, things are now allowed. And now this is the key of the keys of the keys. Aboisai nevoreif. This is the key word here. What is the key word? Velachshoi machshovois machkimois pesi. You cannot be stupid. You cannot be stupid. You have the things, machshavos, that makes you not to be stupid. This is soy gadol. You see, because the world, the definition of the world makes you stupid. All the computers, all like this, not the thing. Not the thing. They do it for you, the work. I have a count, how much, 110 plus 20, plus 50 years ago, we used to do it ourselves. But our train, not only the calculation of things like that, to train, you have to think not to be stupid. Sometimes you go traveling a car, yes, where's this road? Think yourself, 2 minutes, you can figure out yourself. You know, there's a lot of things in life a person does.
23rd follows 24. 24
and 24. A lot of things is, a lot of things that people do is trained to be stupid. There's a lot of things we think stupid. And again, we have habits of stupidness. And a lot of things, you know, if you look, deepness is very deep, and very deep, and very deep. And all Mishlei, you look at Mishlei, a full of it, he writes, okay, Mishlei, so many Mishlei, don't be stupid. Lei chachome, mean of exib smaloi. You know, it's stupid. The chiddush is, and it says here, what you have to do, think thoughts that makes you, not to make you stupid, to make you smart. If you know, before you come to Shiur, you have to prepare yourself. And you need this and this and that before. So you prepare. If you don't prepare, you don't know it because that makes you stupid, because you don't prepare yourself. You don't think before. A lot of things is I can count a billion things what to do. It's not the point. The point is we have to train our mind not to be stupid. Think, machshavos machkimos pesin. That makes you smart, doesn't make you stupid.
Thinking makes you not stupid.
Think thoughts that doesn't make you, thoughts that make you stupid.
Which thoughts that don't make you stupid?
Learning Torah, mitzvahs, or things, you know, things. You know, you have to, you see. And v'zehu atanis hayot yotov. This is the biggest, and this is the biggest fast. You would think the fast, not the physical body. This is a harder time. Not to think, you know, think how to, you know, think how to make yourself, not, to be smart. And to be smart, you know, if I do this, I do that, you know, not only in the physical world, also learning Torah and davening and Avodas Hashem and I, you know. I'll give you a motion to understand. We're talking about davening today. You have to think about Klali Yisrael davening. You stand in front of the king of the world. Three times a day standing for the king of the world. Hashem is the king of the world. And three times a day, you're standing in front of the king of the world. You can ask him everything you want.
You can't ask it for yourself.
No, you can't ask it for Klali Yisrael. We can ask anything for you want, what you want. Don't be stupid. You take the moment, look, and you forget. You don't even think. You don't even ask nothing. You come to the front of the king.
Rosh Hashiva once told the student, he says, I know what you got for his money. How much did you ask for? $1 million? You asked for $1 million? Why don't you ask for $1 billion? Selfish.
The point is, we have to
machkim us.
No, you see, not always, you see, again. And we got three assignments today. How much you closer to Hashem? You have to ask Hashem to be close to Hashem. Or you have to ask five, you need things or good things you need. Or you want to understand better. So, but all these things in the end get you more responsibility, more work. So you think, see, and the nature is, we don't want to work. We want to be free zombies, free walking people, not thinking. So We don't want to daven. We don't want to do it. We don't want to live like an animal because we don't want to take responsibility because we don't even understand. We don't want to. We want to close our eyes and not to really work and not to ask. Not this. Not. We're so far away from it because we don't want to take responsibility because it takes us. How much we know more, it gives us more responsibility. How much you have more things in the world gives more responsibility. How much you're close to Hashem is more responsibility. So, you're stuck. But don't be stupid. You have opportunity. You have opportunity. Tug doyle toyro. Because two gdoyle Torah is said clearly. Listen to this. Two gdoyle Torah, two. They said clearly. Clearly they said on themselves. One is Avionis and Ivishitz. Avionis and Ivishitz said clearly. And the Avionis and Ivishitz were so smart that all he knew, all the technology of today, even today, using the people that going use today how to make the genius, how genius it was. He says, I'm a genius not because I was born genius, because I daven, I asked Hashem to make me genius. He says it clearly. Don't think you say, I came genius because I was born genius. And you see, even today, all the going, they see how smart he was. So, he himself is two gdolim said himself. Two giants. They said, you know why I came smart? Not because I came smart. I was born that way. Maybe he was smart, but he was came the giant of giantess is called it. And Yonis Ivich is considering going not only Torah, he knew all the world things, you know. Because he asked Hashem. Like a, so the asking Hashem, this is the secret. Asking Hashem is the secret. Begging Hashem and asking Hashem, please help me what I need. This is a secret of life. Begging, asking Hashem. And who else was it? The Chazon Ish. The Chazon Ish, he knew all about her medicine. Chuta is a god of the Torah. He used to tell the biggest doctors in all the world how to make operations. On the spot. You make this operation, ask him what you knew. He says from davening Hashem. So two gdoyle Torah that they say clearly. I mean, it's a lot, but one is Avionis and Ivishitz, and another one is the Chazon Ish. They said clearly, and both are going to Torah. And they're not only Torah, and also in the world, they knew about medicine, and everything they knew about. So how they came, and they said clearly, it came from Tfilah. It came from David. So, we learned today, big foundation, how you have to change. How a davening has to change? Refoeinu idam for klal Yisrael. Borech oleinu idam for klal Yisrael. Ato choinen lo dom das ula choneinu is klal Yisrael. Idam for the klal. And we like the Leviim have to serve klal Yisrael. And we have to daven for klal Yisrael. That everybody have a full shleim, everybody have a chacham. Ah, we daven, we have to daven. Elokein etzor eshoni mero, or shma koleinu. They daven when you want to daven. They daven, shma koleinu, this is daven aside. It's enough there to daven when you need. Or, if you daven for the klal, you might see it after. After you say for the klal, you might see it for yourself also. Well, how you want to do it. But the point is, this is a Mussar who has changed. How we have the strength to daven as well? Because we are the Leviim, and Hashem gave us an opportunity to learn Torah and to serve in the temple of Hashem. Today the temple of Hashem is the Beis Medrash. So we have a job to care about Klal Yisrael. So we have to daven for Klal Yisrael, and daven, everyone has a responsibility to care about Klal Yisrael, and for daven for Klal Yisrael. All the problems what we need and all the problems. And this everyone's responsibility and has the strength of that God. So Hashem will help us to change our prayer to pray for the cloud, for all the Jewish nation. And everything comes to Hashem. And you think for yourself, Hashem will not give you. When you die for the cloud, you grow. Minor. And Hashem doesn't forget about it. You have also things with that Hashem will take care of. B'tor Sha'ar. And with that for Rafaim, what do you say? B'tor Sha'ar Kalisot. In yourself, put yourself part of the cloud. Shabbat Shalom.